Well, I've got the top of the hour, so we'll get started here. Welcome, everyone. I hope you're all doing well. I'd like to thank you all for taking time out of your day to join this webinar. I'm your host, Corey Schneider, a business development manager with Presto Geosystems. I've been with Presto for over 14 years and have extensive experience with all of the products and applications we will be covering today. We manufacture erosion control, stormwater management, and porous pavement products and are located in northern Wisconsin. All of our products are manufactured right here in Wisconsin and sold through distribution throughout the country and the world. Here are the things I hope you get out of today's presentation. I want you to understand how our products can provide solutions in building roads as well as along roadways. Understand how geocells work in challenging soil environments. Learn about the different applications where geocells can be used in road building, and learn how they can help manage stormwater and stabilize slopes in right-of-ways. Everyone's muted for this webinar, so if there are any questions during the presentation, please type them into the question window and I'll answer them at the end. First, a little background on Presto. We did work with the Army Corps of Engineers to develop geocell technology back in the late 70s, and we have been innovating ever since. Our products have been used in over 200 countries and in every state in the US. We do pride ourselves in going beyond simply providing a product. We do provide a lot of design and construction resources. Those are available on our website, or you can reach out to us in person. We've got experienced engineers on staff and do provide free project evaluations for any project that you're looking at potentially using GEOWEB for. If we do get that far where you're going to do an installation, we can provide contractor support. Either somebody from the main office here in Wisconsin or one of our experienced distributors will be on site to make sure the product gets installed not only correctly but also as efficiently as possible. We operate in three product areas, generally speaking, with our GEOWEB geocells, which can be used for load support, slope and channel protection, and constructing green retaining walls. So that would be our soil stabilization category. We also have a line of porous pavements, both vegetated and aggregate solutions. And we do have lightweight reusable construction mats. Today, we're going to focus on GEOWEB, mainly in load support, but we'll also touch on the other three applications as well. A little general information about geocells to get started. The GEOWEB system consists of two main attributes. We've got the infill type, which we'll get into in a moment. And then the second main attribute is going to be the cell size. The cells come in three different diameters. So we have a small cell, which is about 8 by 9 inches, a mid-sized cell, about 11 by 12 inches. And our large cell is about 18 by 20 inches. And then each one of these cell sizes can come in 3, 4, 6, or 8 inch depth. So the cell size and cell depth combination is going to depend on the project details and your loading requirements. And that's something we can recommend through that project evaluation service. The seam strength is very important to the function of a geocell. The stronger the seam strength, the better the geocell will function. The strong seam will allow for heavier infill material and better lifetime performance. And the strength of the panel material itself, in our case, virgin high-density polyethylene, is also critical to the strength and performance of a geocell system. Here we can see a typical GEOWEB panel. It comes tri-folded and palletized, as you can see in the lower right-hand corner. Each section has a nominal width of 8.5 feet with lengths up to 58 feet long. The panels are flexible, opening like an accordion, so they can follow the natural contours of the worksite without being confined to a rigid set of dimensions. Our GeoWeb is also equipped with numerous design and construction components that increase the strength and speed of the installation. Over on the left-hand side would be our staking components. So up on top, we've got the Atra stake clip. Typically, this will fit right on top of a half-inch diameter rebar. You simply pound the rebar into the ground and hook one of the arms over the cell walls. If we are worried about that rebar corroding long term, we can provide a fiberglass rod or a completely plastic anchor as well. With any of our anchors, we do have a GAD that works with a pneumatic driver, fits right over the top of the head very snugly. So that allows you to very quickly pneumatically drive those stakes into the ground instead of hand pounding them all in. We've got the Atra key that we use to connect the sections together. And then when we use a tendon system, which we'll talk a little bit more about later, we have an Atra tendon clip that will transfer the loads and spread them evenly throughout the GeoWeb panel. So a little bit more in depth on the Atra key. The old way to connect panels together was a stapled connection. So these keys are going to provide about 3 times the connection strength of staple. They're also made out of plastic, so they're not gonna rust long-term. They're about twice as fast as staples for the installation process. You also don't need any tools or compressors on site for the installation. So it's a very easy, quick way to connect the panels together, both side to side and end to end. The Atra tendon clip also has some advantages when anchoring with tendons. So much like the key, it's a turn and lock system so that once you lock the tendon into the slot, you can use both hands to wrap the tendon around it. This is going to save a lot of time, and it also will allow for a top of slope assembly. So you can assemble the entire section at the top of the slope with the tendon and the tendon clips and drape the whole thing over to minimize the amount of time where workers are actually on the slope doing the installation. We'll now move on to discuss our soil stabilization capabilities using the GeoWeb cellular confinement system as they relate to roads and highways. Presto offers solutions for many different road and highway applications. Under load support, we can do both paved and unpaved roads. We can do road shoulders and space stabilization beneath pavements. Slope stabilization encompassing embankment slopes, bridge abutments, and retaining walls, as well as stormwater control is being possible with the geocells through roadside ditches, drainage channels, and culvert outfalls. The purpose of cellular confinement is very simple. We're going to stabilize the movement of unstable soils both horizontally and vertically. The weaker the subgrade conditions, the more practical the insertion of the GeoWeb system is into the design. It's an engineered system integrating multiple types of geosynthetics with the best method of confinement and subgrade stress reduction in the industry. The GeoWeb system can reduce your cross-section by as much as 70% or more by distributing the load evenly over wide areas to enhance the load-bearing capacity. The GeoWeb three-dimensional system works this way. When a vertical load is applied, the active earth pressure in the loaded cell pushes back against the passive earth pressure in the adjacent cell to form a stable system. Each cell helps support the ones around it. The GeoWeb cell walls also transfer hoop stress, which is important in keeping the system intact, and it creates a mattress effect. The strength of the seams around each cell, the material properties of the individual strips, and the connection method between panels are all important factors in determining how the geocell system can improve load-bearing capacity. Strong seams, semi-ductile resin properties, and integrated connections are critical to a well-performing system. The GeoWeb system and accessories are specifically designed to work together to be an effective solution for roads in soft soil locations. Here you can see the stresses on the subgrade with the unsupported subgrade on the left and the GEOWEB reinforcement on the right. Notice how there is a complete elimination of the highest stresses at the surface with GEOWEB reinforcement. The stresses are reduced and distributed over a wider area, which we call the mattress effect. This mattress effect reduces stress reaching the subgrade and leads to significant decrease in deflection and rutting. We'll take a quick look at how GEOWEB performs in the lab to give you an idea of the benefits your project can see. The first test we'll look at, we had a supersaturated peat mixture that was put under varying loading with 8-inch GEOWEB on top of the peat compared to 8 inches of unconfined aggregate. There was settlement plates and were placed and a load beam was placed over the section and loaded to failure. The peat pit test showed that bases reinforced with GEOWEB provide a significant improvement over unreinforced soils. For a loading of 1,000 pounds per foot, a 4-inch depth rut or 4-inch depth rut occurred in the GEOWEB section, whereas the unreinforced soil had about a 20-inch rut. So a significant improvement on the rut depth. Since the previous test was under static loading, we also performed a repeated dynamic load test. So here the pavement load testing compared reinforced and unreinforced materials consisting of a subbase and various infill materials. Each section was loaded until it experienced 0.6 inch of deformation. For the non-GEOWEB section, this took about 25,000 load cycles. When we added GEOWEB into the section, the number of load cycles went up to 400,000. So we had an increase of 16 times the number of load cycles, which you can imagine how this would improve the life cycle cost of any pavement. As mentioned, we do provide design evaluations, and our unpaved road calculation is based on stress reduction. We calculate the stress below each layer until we get it far enough below the allowable stress on the subgrade based on the given subgrade strength. So typically we're going to design these load support applications with a factor of safety of at least 1.4. We certainly can make that factor of safety as high as you're comfortable with. So 1.4 would be the standard, but anything you request, we can meet. Here you can see the impressive load support benefits. We've got an 80,000 pound loaded dump truck on partially filled GEOWEB panels over a soft subgrade. You can see how the cells push back against each other to support the load and that only the adjacent cells need to be filled for support to take place. That's a great benefit to using the GEOWEB system because you don't have to have every cell completely filled before the road is usable. You can reduce construction time and materials with this approach by basically working on the GEOWEB areas that you have filled already. The system's often compared to two-dimensional geogrids, and they do start with a similar concept. However, the three-dimensional nature of the GEOWEB panels gives several advantages over grids. The biggest difference is the required fill material. In order to fully function, geogrids require high-quality engineered aggregate, which can be expensive to obtain and haul to a project site. The GEOWEB system, conversely, can be used with low-quality aggregate and even sand. We'll also provide a thinner cross-section. Typically, a 6-inch GEOWEB system is going to be equivalent to about 12-inch geogrid section. And in a 12-inch geogrid section, you're typically going to need two layers of grid. We can also eliminate fines when desired, since the cells provide the confinement and aid compaction of cohesionless soils. So without fines, you can significantly improve drainage and let the water flow freely through the system, preventing pore pressure buildup and global failure of the cross section. Additionally, geogrids do little to stabilize the surface, requiring significantly more maintenance since the aggregate is loose at the surface and can be pushed around by vehicle passes. Continuing with the theme of the unpaved gravel surface road application, a washed or clear stone can be used in the GEOWEB, allowing you to build stable, permeable, low impact development access roads. Site access roads, both temporary and permanent, are a very common application for the GEOWEB system. As mentioned, heavy loaded vehicles can drive on it immediately after infilling to finish construction, which is a huge time saver. With GEOWEB panels and a woven geotextile, you can bridge soft, wet ground, creating access roads with little to no disturbance. Saturated soils usually can't support any type of vehicle load, but woven geotextiles can add an additional strength layer to the system, and they won't get clogged by the subgrade material while still allowing water movement as necessary. The clean stone infill combined with the perforations in the GEOWEB cell walls allow water to flow both vertically and laterally through the system, limiting impact in sensitive environmental locations in ways that paved asphalt or concrete roads cannot. The GEOWEB system can support all highway traffic loading, making it a great option for extending shoulder areas along all types of roadways. The panels can be filled with either aggregate or an engineered fill. And for our purpose, an engineered fill is going to be a 2/3 clean stone, 1/3 topsoil mix that will allow for full vegetation growth while supporting vehicle loads. Both infill types can widen roads for emergency access and help to manage stormwater runoff from the impervious asphalt pavement by allowing the stormwater to infiltrate, which is going to reduce the erosion concerns at pavement edges. Building on that thought of stormwater infiltration, just want to re-clarify that the GEOWEB system can create a true porous pavement system. The water can infiltrate at the point of impact, reducing surface runoff and reducing or possibly even eliminating the need for additional stormwater infrastructure such as detention ponds. Porous pavements can be a tricky thing to get through regulators, but we do have a lot of material on our website that can help, and we're always happy to discuss in detail on a project-specific basis. Now we're going to switch from using the GEOWEB system as the road surface to using it for road-based stabilization. Again, the GEOWEB can be used in place of or in conjunction with the traditional aggregate layer underneath a paved asphalt or concrete road surface. The same stiffening effects from the GEOWEB panels that we just discussed still apply here, with the system helping to bridge over soft soils and adding strength to weak subgrades. When used as a base layer, those stiffening effects are translated up through the surface layer, keeping the paved surface stable and in place, and reducing maintenance requirements. Plus, the GEOWEB system can allow for a thinner cross section, again up to about 70%, which means there's going to be less excavation required on site. The same benefits still apply when it's used as a base layer. The ability to use low quality aggregate or granular material is huge, meaning you can use on site or salvage materials in many times. Again, you don't have to worry about importing expensive, difficult to obtain engineered fill. The stress reduction capacity of the panels will reduce the potential for deformation or settlement when placed over soft soils, which means you aren't going to see alligator cracking and wheel ruts forming at the surface. A stronger base layer means a stronger surface layer and longer pavement lifetimes with less maintenance or section replacement. This is a pretty common project that we see. I'm sure we've all dealt with roads like the one in the upper left-hand corner. Surface cracking, ruts, lots of patched areas that seem to start failing almost immediately. This is what happens when the road is built over a weak base layer that can't fully support the vehicle traffic. With the GEOWEB system, the failed asphalt and base layers are removed, the panels laid down and filled with a granular material, and then a fresh paved surface is placed over the panels. Now you have a strong base leading to a strong surface that will look cleaner and last much longer with much less patching and maintenance required. The system can be used under all types of roadways, from private drives to full service highways, like this project for the New Mexico State Highway and Transportation Department. Here, they weren't able to proceed in a timely manner with any of the conventional alternatives, such as deep excavation with thick base layers, or using chemical stabilizers on the extremely soft subgrade. So the DOT turned to the Presto GEOWEB system. Using the GEOWEB, they were able to infill it with local sand material. Here they used a 6-inch GEOWEB under the asphalt pavement and installed nearly 200,000 square feet of the sand-filled GEOWEB, which went in the ground quickly and inexpensively, solving the DOT's budget and construction issues. We'll now move on to embankment stabilization using GEOWEB geocells. Many times slopes and embankments need to be stabilized after or in conjunction with road and highway construction. The system for slopes can be filled with several different materials depending on your project needs. Topsoil and vegetation is certainly the most common, but sometimes vegetation is not appropriate, so stone and concrete are also options. Here's a simplified diagram showing how the different system components interact with the GEOWEB to form a complete system. The first thing to go down is going to be the geosynthetic layer. Generally, we're only going to use a geosynthetic if we have aggregate or concrete infill. We typically try to stay away from separation when we have a topsoil infill because we don't want to impede root growth into the subgrade. The GEOWEB is then placed. Note how it has a horizontal turn near the top of the slope. This is important for crest anchorage as well as erosion control. As shown earlier, we have several options for anchoring. One is using stakes with an Atra stake clip. These are placed mid-slope and at the crest. The number and spacing of the stakes is project dependent. It'll depend on the slope length and the slope angle, as well as the cohesion of the subgrade material. Remember that we do also have plastic or fiberglass stake options if long-term corrosion is a concern. Another anchorage option then would be to use the tendons and a dead man. And the dead man is typically going to be a buried pipe, but it can be a concrete anchor or earth or rock anchors at the crest are also options. The GEOWEB's then filled with the desired infill material. And if vegetated, we typically will put an erosion control blanket over the top or hydroseed to prevent washout prior to the establishment of vegetation. The GEOWEB works in multiple ways to protect the slope surfaces. It will prevent significant movement of the soil by confining it into individual cells. By separating the soil into smaller segments, the system resists mobilization of the entire slope face due to hydraulic loads and prevents soil erosion. It's important to reiterate that proper installation of the GEOWEB includes embedding the panels into the crest of the slope. This is going to prevent water from flowing beneath the GEOWEB and undermining the system. So no rills or gullies will form beneath the panel, and which could potentially lead to failure. The system provides a way to fully vegetate slope surfaces that otherwise could not support sustainable plant life, and it will increase the overall slope stability by interlocking with the vegetated root zone. Stone and concrete materials can also be confined within the GEOWEB panels, again on slopes that normally would be too steep to allow for natural stone. Vegetated slopes are certainly the most popular option because they can result in the most attractive slopes with little to no maintenance. It's important to note that the GEOWEB slope protection system is for surface erosion issues only. Because the panels are laid over the slope face, the system does not assist in globally stabilizing the slope. If that is a concern, other measures need to be taken, and we'll talk about that in a minute. If the slope is stable but seeing failure due to stormwater erosion or saturated soil movement, the GEOWEB slope protection system can help. The slope protection system is intended for shallow to steep slopes, generally between 15 and 45 degrees. So we use 1:1 as the limit for slope angles, mainly for construction purposes, but if required, we can get steeper than that. Again, as long as the slope is globally stable. We've successfully completed projects with slope angles up to about 60 degrees, but just be aware that if you get over about 45, the installation will be much more labor intensive. A lot of times slopes can't be graded down to something shallow enough to prevent erosion on its own. So using the GEOWEB system allows for these steeper slopes to be reliably covered. This slope alongside a road in Ohio is a common problem that is solved with the GEOWEB system. Erosion and washout of soil slopes onto road surfaces is a problem in many locations. Covering the slope with GEOWEB and filling with topsoil allows for a vegetated slope without the concern of having to constantly replace the soil after storm events. We do recommend that some sort of surface protection, such as hydroseeding or an erosion control blanket, be used over the panels until vegetation has had a chance to get established. Embankments along roadways have to deal with sheet flow runoff from the impervious surface of the roadway, like the slope we see here, which is a Maryland State Highway Administration project. The sheet flow can cause sloughing of large sections of the upper topsoil layer, causing deep rills or gullies and preventing vegetation from taking hold. The GEOWEB system holds the soil in place while allowing the water to run over the surface, so there'll be no more gullies and vegetation can form deep roots to further stabilize the slope. Road widening is becoming more common with DOTs trying to find more roadway space without displacing any significant structures. So the slopes or embankments are usually where that space can be found, such as this road widening project in New Hampshire. The GEOWEB slope protection system allowed for steeper slopes to be created without erosion concerns. The system can be installed quickly and vegetated quickly, so there isn't a long construction time that could shut down the important roads. Ease and speed of construction are important features of the system that everyone appreciates. This was actually installed by the local highway crew as well, so they didn't even need to bring in any specialized contractors, which was a significant cost savings on this project. Here's a project in Pennsylvania highlighting an issue that we haven't covered so far, which is geomembrane protection. On this project, the highway cut exposed pyrite-bearing sandstone to air and rain, creating the potential for acid rock drainage. To remediate this, an impervious geomembrane was installed over the slope face, and then the GEOWEB on top of that. The liner needs to be protected so that it doesn't get punctured, which would allow air and water through, defeating the purpose. And with the GEOWEB system on top of the liner, and anchored with our tendon system, which again will not need any puncturing of the liner, the topsoil infill is going to prevent long-term damage to that liner. This is also a great way to cover landfills or to protect drainage ponds that may have impervious liners to stop chemical or waste leaching as well. As I mentioned, we can go very steep if needed. Here we see a highway project in Peru that ended up with five terraces of slopes that were 0.75 to 1, or about 54 degrees. The slopes were all MSE structures and included geogrid reinforcement to ensure the global stability of each terrace. Once these were constructed, the GEOWEB panels were placed over the face. And due to the steep slope angle, they had to be pretty much hand-filled with topsoil, because we couldn't get any construction equipment onto the slope. So again, it's possible to get very steep, but just be aware that it's going to be a lot of handwork over about 45 degrees. Aggregate infill can provide a low maintenance solution, and it's great for areas where vegetation may not grow easily or where stone is more common and less expensive. Aggregate infill allows for water infiltration, so it can collect runoff from road surfaces and it can be kept clean fairly easily. Here, the Minnesota DOT used the GEOWEB to help stabilize the surface around bridge abutments and along railroad tracks and crossings. The flexible nature of the panels means it can easily contour to the slope face and around obstacles such as piles and abutments. With the system in place, water erosion is prevented around the abutments, reducing maintenance costs. The entire project was a mixture of topsoil and vegetation and aggregate infill, with aggregate being used below the bridges where vegetation would have been difficult to establish due to a lack of sunlight. Concrete infill is the last main infill type that we'll discuss. The system, of course, would no longer be considered permeable, but there is no maintenance requirements with a concrete filled GEOWEB, and the embankments can handle significant amounts of stormwater runoff if needed. The panels are going to act as the formwork for the concrete and as the internal reinforcement, so you won't need any forms or rebar. The concrete is poured directly into the panels and screeded to the top of the cell walls, ensuring a consistent concrete depth without it slumping to the toe of the slope. I've mentioned a few times that the GEOWEB slope protection system does not help with the global stability of the slope. If global stability is a concern, or if we're looking at, say, 65 degree face or steeper, then we should think about building these as a retaining wall. The panels can be stacked vertically on top of one another to create a gravity retaining wall, and geogrid tieback reinforcements can be added if necessary, similar to MSE block or gabion basket walls. The walls can be filled with topsoil in the front cell to create living green walls and can be built to support vehicle or building loads as well. Here are the two different wall options in cross section. So on the left, we've got a gravity wall where we use longer pieces of GEOWEB at the bottom. They get shorter as you go up, and the weight of the infilled GEOWEB is what provides your soil retention. Typically, we only construct these gravity walls up to about 8 feet or so. After that, they get a little cost prohibitive. So for taller walls, we will generally go with a geogrid reinforced or MSE structure. And here it's the geogrid that's going to do all the retention work, where the GEOWEB is merely a fascia alternative. In either case, again, the front cell is filled with topsoil and the back cells and reinforced zone use any sort of drainable material. Here's an Ohio DOT project where we've got a 20-foot high wall that was constructed to keep the rock face from eroding further. The GEOWEB system is the fascia that helps to protect the road without taking up a lot of horizontal space. In this case, the maximum embedment depth is only 7 feet, as we weren't retaining anything, but rather simply building a freestanding structure to protect that rock face. Now on to our last topic for the day, using GEOWEB for stormwater control in place of typical stormwater infrastructures along roadways. The GEOWEB channel protection system is very similar to the slope system. We can cover either the entire channel cross section or just do single embankments. We can do continuous or intermediate flow, low to high flow, and a variety of channel dimensions with the GEOWEB system due to its flexible nature. The system is more economical than solutions that utilize large riprap stone or heavy gabion baskets, and several different infill material options are available to meet any channel flow needs. The system can be placed along the embankments of stormwater channels to help prevent erosion due to fluctuating water levels. Low flow situations are easily handled by vegetated GEOWEB systems, creating a natural looking embankment without intensive maintenance requirements. And again, the system does not need to cover the bottom of the channel, especially if we have continuous low flow water in the bottom. The type of vegetation within the panels is not important to the function of the system. So choosing panels that are native to the area and are okay with the occasional soaking will be a big help in reducing potential maintenance. As I mentioned, the vegetated system has a lower cost than riprap line channels, since you can use local topsoil and you won't need to import and install those large stones. There's less maintenance as well, since riprap channels need constant inspection to replace lost stone and remove weeds. With a vegetated channel, the only maintenance is your occasional mowing, which can be done with your standard lawnmower. No special equipment is required. And finally, vegetated channels have a better aesthetic than your riprap channels. Extensive research was performed at Colorado State University to show how the vegetated GEOWEB system can perform in channel conditions. What was found was that when paired with a turf reinforcement mat, the combination system can resist extremely high flows, allowing for velocities up to about 30 feet per second and shear stresses of 16 pounds. Compared to the allowable 4 feet per second with unconfined vegetated channels, this is a huge improvement. The turf reinforcement mat prevents soil from scouring out of the cells, while the GEOWEB prevents supersaturated soils from washing downstream during high flow events, which is why this combination system works so well in tandem. We also tested aggregate infill. So for this test, and again at Colorado State, we did three different cell sizes and two different rock sizes and ran a total of 90 tests. So with all those data points, they were able to run a regression analysis. And with that analysis, they came up with a regression equation, which given the bed slope and unit discharge of any specific channel, we can manipulate the rock size and the cell size until we get to a point where your rock loss L is zero. So when we compare our rock sizing tool to the traditional ones of Abs and Johnson and the Army Corps of Engineers, we find that through confinement, you're able to reduce your rock size anywhere from 2 to 10 times. That is a pretty large variance, and it's mostly dependent on your bed slope. The flatter the bed slope, the greater we can reduce your rock size. And even a 2 times reduction in rock size can generally lead to significant savings in your rock costs, as well as your transportation and installation costs. And finally, concrete infilled channels. This particular project that I'm showing here is a water conveyance channel in Colorado. The cross section is a geomembrane sandwiched with two layers of geotextile. And then our GW30V3, which is our mid-sized cell, 3 inches deep, filled with 3,000 PSI concrete. Here we, of course, used tendons for the anchorage, as we couldn't puncture the geomembrane. It's important to note that studies by the Bureau of Reclamation show that the concrete-filled GEOWEB is the most cost-effective, lowest maintenance solution for their water conveyance channels. Again, once the GEOWEB is installed, it acts exactly like a concrete form. So here the concrete is pumped into the cells. If you do have access, like you can see in the lower right-hand corner, the concrete can be poured directly into the cells. Then again, we screed and finish right to the top of the cell walls. Notice the picture on the right, the extreme flexibility of these concrete-filled GEOWEB panels. Basically, each cell wall acts as a joint, So that allows it to be quite flexible, and it will flex with subgrade deformation, which will help to minimize cracking. And here we can see, again, tested at Colorado State University with some pretty impressive results. The 3-inch filled cells were able to withstand 36 feet per second and 21 pounds of shear without failure, but rather we maxed out the flume. This stormwater channel project in Florida shows how the GEOWEB retaining wall system can be used in water flow environments as well. The stacked system can be used in urban areas where there's no room to lay back side slopes, or in order to handle more volume in the same footprint, which is great for along roads and highways. Vegetation can be used above the waterline for a natural look, with concrete or aggregate used below the waterline to help resist erosion and washout. The system can be used in conjunction with riprap, like we see here. The riprap is generally going to be for scour protection in these types of applications when we have very high flows, like in this culvert outfall in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Stronger surface protection over the panels, such as a turf reinforcement mat or core fabric, can be used to withstand these high flow events. This one is intended for short duration events rather than continuous flow. If it is continuous flow, then you would probably not try to vegetate the front face at all and just fill it with aggregate or concrete. The flexible panels can easily accommodate culvert pipes or other obstacles, so there are no gaps in protection. And including sonnet tubes allows for the addition of guardrail posts like we can see here. We often hear from contractors how easy it is to install the GEOWEB system, even if they have never worked with it before, and how it goes in place much faster and easier than gabion baskets or H-pile walls. So even if it looks complicated at first, anyone can get the hang of it. We do have written instruction or installation guides and tutorial videos on our website, as well as providing on-site assistance when required. So training is pretty simple and comprehensive. In summary, every project is different, but the GEOWEB system has a solution that is right for you. The system can be added to road projects to provide a more stable and longer lasting surface course for unpaved roads, which will reduce maintenance and repairs. For paved surfaces, GEOWEB decreases pressure on the subgrade to reduce differential and long-term settlement, which will extend pavement life. The ability to use low-quality aggregate or even sand can be a significant cost savings. And whether you're looking to stabilize your roadway, protect your embankments, or manage your stormwater runoff, the GEOWEB system has great flexibility of design to meet your project needs. And it is a complete system solution for ease of installation and peace of mind. Part of our complete solution is our technical assistance. The engineering team here at Presto works closely with landscape designers and engineers. Again, we do offer a free project evaluation service for any road, embankment, or erosion control project. The form can be found on our website, prestogeo.com. Should just take 5 or 10 minutes to complete. Just give us as much information as you have available. Also allows you to attach documents such as geotechnical reports. And then when you submit it, it will go to the engineering team. And within 3 business days, but usually faster, we will provide a complete design evaluation, including cell size and cell depth recommendation, infill and anchorage requirements. And basically we'll work with you to get you the best design for your project. So it's not uncommon for us to do several iterations to make sure that we get you a solution that will work for your project. So here's my contact info, corey.schneider@prestogeo.com. If any questions come up later, please feel free to send me an email. You will be getting a follow-up email in the next few days. In it will be a link to this recorded webinar that'll be on our YouTube channel, so you could share this with others who missed the presentation or use it for review in the future. You'll also get instructions for receiving your certificate for the one PDH credit that you've earned for attending today. So now I'm going to go to the question box and take care of anything that came up during the course of the presentation. Anyone that's got to leave, I just want to say thanks a lot for attending. And we will go to the questions right now. Starting at the top, how many of the connectors are required? So for the ATRA keys, we do require them in every cell because that's going to basically create another cell of the same size when you connect the panels together. So we don't want to be skipping cells because that's going to make everything, you know, you'd have a larger cell than what the design is required for. Must we use a base layer geotextile? Geotextile is going to be required if our infill material is different than our subgrade material. But if we're just looking for separation, most times we'll just use a inexpensive 8-ounce non-woven. If we are looking for additional strength, that's when we might start to consider enhanced woven geotextiles. For temporary access, can GeoWeb be used? It certainly can be, but it is not very easy to take the material out and have it reusable again. So if it's a temporary access that you're fine leaving in place, then GeoWeb's a good option. If it is something that needs to be removed, then you might want to consider one of our construction mats like our GeoTerra or our GeoTerra GTO. Can I have a copy of the slideshow? So yeah, when you get the email, there'll be a copy or a link to the YouTube channel that will have the full recorded presentation. You can share that one with your boss. What experience do we have using recycled materials in place of quarried aggregates? We do use recycled asphalt and recycled concrete pretty consistently. The only requirement really is that we do want the maximum particle size to be approximately 1/3 the cell depth. So you would want your recycled material to be crushed to the point where it's approximately, say, 2 inches for a 6-inch cell. If used under asphalt, can the asphalt be milled in the future? Yes, it can be. So when we use it below asphalt or concrete, we typically are going to overfill the cells by about 2 inches with our infill material. So that's certainly going to make milling not a problem at all. For public roadways, what's the typical compaction for the infill material? Do you overfill and then apply typical vibratory compaction? So yeah, as I mentioned, what we're going to do is overfill. We don't want to use vibratory compaction, though, just roller compaction. We find that when you vibrate it, there is the potential for that stone to get underneath the GeoWeb, which can cause it to lift up. So I would stay away from vibratory compaction and just use roller compaction, and 95% is just fine. Could it be used to stabilize topsoil piles reserved for site reclamation and oil and gas pad and road construction? It certainly can be used for that. Really, any slopes we can cover and stabilize, so this topsoil piles wouldn't be any different. What is the cost? That really is going to vary significantly, Alfred. If you want to send me an email, you know, we have so many different cell sizes and cell depths, but if you have a specific application in mind, I could certainly get you a rough cost for the GeoWeb. Somebody lost sound. I apologize for that. I don't see anybody else saying it, so hopefully it was just one individual. Can we get a PDF of the presentation? This is from Carl. Yeah, that certainly wouldn't be a problem, Carl. Again, it'll be on our YouTube channel, but if you'd prefer a PDF, you can send me an email, corey.schneider@prestogeo.com, which you can still see on the screen. I'd be happy to PDF that and send it to you. Can you repeat the maximum angle or maximum slope angle? Again, if your slope is globally stable, we have done slope protection at 60 degrees. Standard recommendation would be 1:1 or 45 degrees. As you get steeper than that, you do you are able to do it, but it does take a lot of handwork and can get a little expensive. Are the in-house engineers registered? Will they seal the drawings? They are registered in many states, but we actually do not seal any of the drawings. Our distributors typically are going to work with local engineers for any projects that do need to get stamped. So while our engineers won't do it, they'll do a lot of the work and work with the local engineer to ensure he's comfortable enough to stamp it. Do we have longevity studies? I mean, we've done accelerated lab testing that the GeoWeb will not begin to break down for well over 100 years. It is made out of high density polyethylene, which is one of the materials most inert to chemicals and the environment that there are. We do have in-ground projects for over 40 years, so they're going to last quite a long time. Has the GeoWeb been used for green roofs anywhere? Yes, it has been. We work with a green roof company out of Chicago to typically accomplish that because we don't deal with the entire cross section of the waterproofing and the low density infill material and things like that. But it has been used on roofs and certainly can be. Do you send PDH? Again, I covered that. You'll have an email with those instructions. Is it capable of handling tractor trailer loads on a road? Yes, HS25 loading is not a problem. Is the video available on YouTube? It isn't yet, but it will be soon. Covered the life cycle. Is installation over a rock surface feasible? You want that rock surface to be as smooth as possible. But typically what we would do is use tendons, so we're not trying to drive stakes into the rock, and generally use a geotextile separation layer to make sure we hold the soil into the cells. Used in fully submerged applications, yes, it has been. We've got applications where divers actually have been incorporated to anchor the material below existing water, so can happen. It does have a specific gravity that's very close to one, so while it doesn't float, it doesn't exactly sink either. So if you're going to install it under the water, you're going to need to help manually get it into place. Can it be used on cracked slopes? Yeah, but again, we would want to use a geotextile separation layer. What's the technical standard? Both ASTM and ASHTO test methods do apply. At times, we repair or reconstruct the street section and the subgrade saturated clay. Excavate to try to find the bottom. So basically, the question is, can you use this instead of over excavation? And the answer is yes, absolutely. You can basically create a bridge over these soft soils so you can eliminate the need to over ex. The rock in our slide seems to be crushed stone. They have a lot of rounded in the west. We do definitely prefer to use crushed stone because it does lock up better within the cells. But if you do, I mean, depending on your specific application, something that's more on the rounded side than the crushed side might be okay. I wouldn't use rounded stone for unpaved roads, but they might work okay as long as they're slightly angular below pavements. As to vegetation, can the system sustain damage that may be caused by large trees? Yeah, we've got 30, 40 year old slope installations where large trees are growing out of them. And I mean, it's flexible enough, so if roots start pushing it up, it'll conform to that. If your tree trunk gets larger than the cell opening, it'll simply pop one of the cells, which isn't going to hurt the overall stability of the full slope. So large trees are not a problem. All right, that looks like all of the questions. So once again, thanks everyone for attending today, and be on the lookout for that email, which will have the link to the YouTube presentation as well as instructions for how to get your PDH. Again, if you want to jot down my email, Corey, Corey.Schneider@PrestoGeo.com. And if any questions do come up as you're sitting around thinking about GeoWeb the rest of the day, just shoot me an email and we can discuss one-on-one. All right, take care, everyone. Have a good day.